Yep.
To see the breakdown of movement by movement, position by position, and then those drills turning into throws was really good to see.
All right.
Putting the hurdles down and we had them going through the hurdle with their right foot, that is kind of like my aha moment for, I actually know which throw I'm gonna make do that all summer. Better.
Go. We're teaching you to stay back with as much power as possible.
We want to establish for you guys a simple, repeatable model proven to work.
Up, drop in, two taps. We got to do about another 10 or 20 of these and then we'll go into the advanced movement.
I love the fact that I know exactly where we're going with it and I know exactly what's going to happen at the end.
Up.
We work very hard not to isolate anybody by age or ability. Everybody is moved en masse. And everybody's asked to do the exact same movements.
The number one thing that we do that has to be in place in our technique is we have a thing that we call extension for rotation.
The younger the athlete, the more they improve at our clinics because they just learn. They go quick, quick, quick through these things and they just go boom, boom, boom.
In?
Usually it's not a senior that gets our most improved athlete at the clinic. It's usually a sophomore, a freshman, or an eighth grader, or a seventh grader, because they learn so much faster.
It's really intense.
The coaching is just fantastic.
A lot of really good drills.
All the different things that you can use, like the medicine balls, the cones, the hurdles, jumping over, it's just all good to throw.
I usually use my upper body more than my lower body, and with this, it teaches you how to stop and put both in sync and in motion, and through that, it just comes together in a way that you wouldn't expect.
It's been incredible. I had no idea it'd be this big and interesting and so much personal coaching. You know, John Godino's been over to him probably half a dozen times already, so, and all the other coaches, it's been really neat.
Not bad, good. Just keep working on setting like we were at the med ball. You really got to see the transformation from going straight up with just a med ball to taking it in the ring with the actual technique breakdown.
That's good.
I learned all the pivoting with my feet and which foot to put the weight on it.
Go.
I got a lot of good coaching and it was, as I said, it was really beneficial.
And go.
Sometimes you feel as a coach in a high school season, you got to rush through progressions. I think the aha moment came in when I was in the classroom kind of listening. There's so many steps, but then when we actually went outside and did all the steps, that it went pretty quickly, getting rid of that sensation that you have to rush because the high school season is so short.
We force our coaches into our coaches education program. They have to deliver our product and our techniques to the athletes.
Everything you're checking every time.
These guys did their homework. They've taken their online tests. They've done everything that they need to make sure that they're quote unquote certified to do this. And then they show up and I'll tell you what, when I listen to them coach, I step back sometimes and just watch.
Where are you lined up at? Where's the cone? Where's the cone?
And they're doing it. They're doing what they're asked to do.
Get up in the air.
Really nice to see guys kind of take the bull by the horns and learn the system.
Up! Yeah.
The Godina name brings a lot of people together.
Great guy, knows his stuff.
You also want to be posed, balanced until you catch it.
He's awesome in that he's doing this for kids.
Really good at what he does.
Very impressive man.
Chest lifts to the sky.
He's like amazing. He's like the best thrower.
He's a real good teacher. He knows his stuff.
Get that hip over there.
He's cool. He's really awesome.
Really funny, makes it a fun atmosphere for everybody.
Up! Yes.
He's good.
Really knows what he's talking about.
It's my first time spinning. I've never spun before, so I really like it, like just learning the spin from scratch, and I feel like I've clearly grown a lot already, so I like it a lot.
I got into bad habits, and now I understand what I'm doing wrong, and I'm fixing, so it's good. My goal this year is to break into the top 10 for my school, which is about 160 feet for discus, and then about 55-ish for shot put.
I'm gonna take away what I was doing wrong before and fixing that and trying to especially work on my form, getting lower, my knees, my hips. And then I also learned hammer for the first time. I was working on the footwork for that.
Nice throw.
And that was really fun.
Stay down and go and go.
My goal would be to win state next year.
Two taps.
And to just work on things that I don't normally work on as far as drills go.
And go.
The biggest contribution we can give is to kind of build a subculture. Right now, throwing is a bit fractured where everybody kind of goes out, finds information, and does their thing. What I like to do is build a system with coaches in different locations.
Nice toss.
Have those coaches enjoy it, learn from it, teach athletes in that location.
Everybody get water.
You get help here that you wouldn't normally get just at practice.
Up.
Such a good camp, and you do a lot of things that you wouldn't think of doing.
Go.
The repetition.
A lot of working hard. This is from the ground up here, the way it should be done.
180, go.
If you want to be a thrower, I think this is the guy we'll see.
I'm really happy I came.
I need to thank everybody for coming out and participating very well.
Beautiful.
Thanks John Godina.
Thanks John Godina. Woo!